Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about brachial plexopathy imaging. Terminology: brachial plexopathy is a condition of injury to more than one brachial plexus nerve root, trunk, or cord, leading to upper extremity contracture. Cranial dysplasia, sequela of brachial plexopathy on developing clinoid and humeroid and humerohead. Most common signs and symptoms depend on the level of injury nerve C5 to G5. Injury C5 nerve leading to weak shoulder, injury to C5 C6 leading to weak shoulder and elbow. Injury of C5, C7, weak shoulder, elbow, and wrist. Whether hip posture. Injury C5, C8, weak shoulder, elbow, wrist, and hand. Injury C1, flail hand, honor syndrome. One to three per 1,000 rebirth in U.S. Uncontrolled gestational diabetes rate up to 25%. Imaging affected and unaffected shoulder imaging for comparison. Radiograph: dysplastic clinoid, winged scapula, top coronoid. Humeral head is small and ovoid. Ultrasound. Use posterior axial approach to cranial humeral joints. Can assess humeral head prior to ossification. Alpha angle. Equal angle between posterior scapula margin and tension to humeral head from posterior edge of clinoid, no more less than 30 degrees. Percentage of humeral head posterior to scapular margin, humeral head ossification center should lie anterior to posterior scapular margin. MRI. Cartilage sensitive GRE and PDFS sequential. Unossified and ossified portion of clinoid and humeral head. Angle of clinoid version. Increased lateral version with increased clinoid humeral dysplasia. More than 5 degree different to unaffected size is abnormal. Percentage of humeral head anterior to scapular line. Around 50% normally. Decrease with increased cranial humeral dysplasia. T1 surface T atrophy of shoulder musculature. Frontal radiograph of the normal right shoulder and abnormal left shoulder. In a 12 years old with clinoid humeral dysplasia secondary to left brachial plexopathy, so a small ovoid left humeral head winging of the left scapula, a hooked coracoid and dysplastic left clinoid. Non-contrasting CT image of the right and left shoulder in the same patient so that the small left humeral head is posterior displaced, articulating with a fall clinoid. GOE MR of abnormal right and normal left shoulder. So a low right clinoid scapular angle and clinoid with the humeral head posterior to the scapular line. Ultrasound image of left shoulder on the top in an infant with left brachial plexopathy, so a very half angle between the posterior scapular margin and the tangents to the humeral head from the posterior clinoid, indicating posterior subluxation. The right alpha angle is normal. This is the frontal radiograph in a 10 years old with a right brachial plexopathy. So a small ovoid right humeral head. This plastic right clinoid and a wing right scapula. Frontal radiograph of the small of both shoulder in a boat with a right brachial plexopathy, so mild dysplasia. Or the right humeral head and right clinoid with mild winging of the scapula. There are anchors within the proximal humeral from latissimus dorsi and teres major tendon transverse. Treatment, conservative, physical therapy, botox injection, and flux reduction. Botox injection for internal of shoulder. Surgical, anterior soft tissue release, plus minus tendon transfer. Artery is used to release clinohumeral ligament, axillary push, and portion of scapularis tendon. Humeral head is reduced. Subscapularis released to extend it further if humeral head cannot be reused at this point. Latissimus dorsi and teres major tendon are transferred. So does spike has suppressed the procedure with shoulder is adduction external rotation. Thank you.